In today's video, I'm going to synthesize a strong oxidizer, sodium bismuthate. This substance can easily oxidize manganese 2 all the way to manganese 7 under room temperature. That's because it contains bismuth 5, which is an abnormal oxidation state for bismuth, because common bismuth compound only contains bismuth 3. Usually, alkaline metal salt is quite soluble in water, like sodium chloride, potassium aluminate, etc. But sodium bismuthate is so insoluble that it has very limited solubility even in the boiling water. It's used in organic synthesis for selectively oxidized functional groups. I'm not going to tell the detail about this, but if you are interested in this, I provided a link in the description. Okay, that's not enough for the introduction, let's get started into the synthesis. Following ingredients is prepared: bismuth metal, sodium persulfate, nitric acid, and sodium hydroxide. Bismuth is a very fragile metal. On smashing, it will crack due to its crystal structure. So I put a piece of it on the bottom of a cup, then smash it with a hammer. Obviously, despite its fragileness, my chemist's arm was too weak to conquer it, so I'll try another method. Bismuth has relatively low melting point, only 274 degrees Celsius. Also, it has the lowest thermal conductivity among all the metals, so melting it will be rather easy. Using a blowtorch, it quickly liquefied in the open air. Apparently, blowtorch is much stronger than my arm. Next, I transferred the bismuth into another cup after cooling, then melted it again. Once it all melted, I poured it in the beaker filled with water. Bismuth solidified as soon as it hit the water. This caused it shaped into very sharp but small metal droplets. First, I put 17 grams of bismuth metal in a beaker, then added 30 milliliters of nitric acid. They mixed together, it produces toxic dark orange-brown nitrogen dioxide fumes, so this reaction must be take place in outside or in a well-ventilated area. As the bismuth dissolved, it converted it into bismuth nitrate. Water soluble bismuth compound is quite toxic, so please handle this carefully. Why don't use stoichiometric amount of nitric acid? That's because bismuth nitrate decomposes into insoluble oxynitrate when pH goes above 2. When all metal dissolved, I tap it around 100 mm mark, then set it aside. Secondly, prepare 120 grams of sodium hydroxide and dissolve in 300 ml of water to create a 10 molar solution. Solution will get quite hot due to the dissolving of sodium hydroxide, but this shouldn't bring to boil. But if you don't want to take any risk of it, adding hydroxide in two portions with a lot of stirring in between. Once solution clear up, set it aside and allow it to cool. Then measure 40 grams of sodium persulfate. Persulfate anion is a strong oxidizer, which can easily oxidize iron 2 to iron 3. This substance can be found in electronic store for etching copper circuit boards. Circuit of sodium persulfate was added into bismuth nitrate solution. Once it clear up, pour it into sodium hydroxide solution with strong stirring to break up any solid chunks. As the reaction took place, temperature will rise about 20 degrees. This is why cooling sodium hydroxide is absolutely required, or it will boil and spray everything around. When temperature stops rising, I roast it to 90 degrees and keep it for 1 hour. If you happily can adjust temperature, just bring it to light boil and die down a little bit. As it reaches 90 degrees, the orange precipitate will turn yellow. According to my previous tests, unlike these yellow precipitants, orange one can oxidize manganese 2 to manganese 7. This indicates that bismuth is actually forming right now. Once past 1 hour mark, I turn off the heat and dilute it with 1 liter of water. Because next step is filtration, but I only have filter funnel. If I filter 10 more alkaline solutions through that, the filter paper will be destroyed completely. So by diluting overall concentration, it can be filtered normally. When sodium bismuthate sank to the bottom, I remove most of the water. One thing you should keep in mind is that sodium bismuthate will degrade in water slowly, so you shouldn't leave it underwater for too long. Then I vacuum filtered the sodium bismuthate. Then I put in a desiccator to dry it. And this is the final product. It's quite interesting that yellow sodium bismuthate turned into orange. And it looked like the orange bismuth compound in the beginning of the reaction. Now it's time to test out if I actually made the correct substance. First, dissolve less than 1 gram of manganese sulfate in about 150 ml of water. Then acidifying with sulfuric acid. Then add some sodium bismuthate powder to it. As you can see, the water slowly turned into characteristic violet color, indicating the existence of permanganate ion. So we actually made it. Alright, that's basically it. If you wanna watch this sort of chemical video, please subscribe, share and like. Any thought is welcome in the comment section below. Now you learn a new method to synthesize sodium bismuthate. This is much accessible compared to bromine method. Thanks for watching, bye!